And now it's Mr. Helmer on behalf of the EFD.
Thank you very much, Madam Chairman. The goals of the Millennium Development Project are, of course, praiseworthy, and few would disagree with them. But I fear that in this House, too often, we have an excited focus on new action and perhaps too little attention to the results of what we have already attempted to do. It has well been said that we do not need to teach the grass to grow, we just need to get the rocks off the lawn. And too often, the rocks on the lawn are rocks that we have put there. In that context, I would like to point to the vital role of energy and electricity in taking people out of absolute poverty. Poor people need electric light so that children can study in the evening. Poor people need refrigeration so they can store food and store vaccines. Poor people need electric cooking so they can be freed of the scourge of wood smoke in poor homes. Now, we've heard Commissioner Piebags speak of sustainability. But unfortunately, when we use the word sustainable in this House, we actually mean unsustainable. And any efforts we make to deny access to cheap electricity fueled by fossil fuels in the third world will do huge damage. I am tired to death of hearing the proposition that poor people are most vulnerable to climate change. Nonsense. Poor people are most vulnerable to our policies designed to mitigate climate change. They will suffer if we do not make sure they have cheap and plentiful energy.
Thank you very much, Mr. Helmer. And now it's,